Hey guys, welcome back. This is Mark. We are continuing our lectures in the Codeless programming course. And in this one, I will be talking about type conversion and type coercion, two concepts that you will actually be running into quite a lot whenever you start working with real data that comes from a database or from an external service, from really anywhere you will have data in your logic. I will demonstrate and illustrate the actual concept of data conversion and type conversion first, just so you can understand and see what's going on, what the actual issue is with a type conversion. To do this, I will create a variable and I will call it number of likes. So let's imagine this is a social app where you deal with likes for your user profiles, blog posts, whatever it is. And I will initialize it with a string, which doesn't really make sense because number of likes is a number, as the variable name suggests. But let's say for some reason that number of likes in the system that you're using really expressed as a string. So let's say it is 25 and you need to perform an operation where you're adding another number to this 25. And for this, if I add a print block, and in here, if I go to math and I will use this block for mathematical operations, you might think that you could just do something like this. So in here, we're taking the value that is in the number of likes variable and you're adding 5. Keep in mind that number of likes variable contains a string, which is 25. And if I were to run this page, the result may not be necessarily predictable. But if you understand how type conversion works in Codeless programming system, that actually makes sense. So what happens here is number of likes contains a string. And whenever you're doing the operation of addition with another number, what happens is this 5 actually gets converted to a string. Okay, and this is actually an example of type coercion. So numbers, whenever you do the plus, whenever you do the addition, are converted to strings whenever you have another argument as a string. And what happens here is these two values are concatenated. So it 25 as a string plus 5, which converts to a string, becomes 255. Now, what we need to do is we somehow need to convert this string into a number. There are couple of different ways you can do that in Codeless. Number one, if you go into text, you will see that there is a block that is called convert to number. So what you can do is you put this convert to number in here, and then the text is going to be your variable. So this variable, whatever the value it contains, which is string 25, will be converted to a number, and then actual mathematical operation will be performed. Let's run this page. And now the result is exactly what we expect it to be. It is 30. What's another way to do the conversion to a number? It is actually multiplying this by 1, because multiplication, and let me do that first and I will explain why it happens. So I'll take this out and I put this in here and then the variable as the first argument and change this to multiplication. Get rid of this and let's rerun this page. Again, the result is 30. It is predictable, exactly what we wanted to do. And then what happens here is whenever there is a multiplication operation and multiplying by 1 in this case, string will be converted to a number. This is an example of type coercion where that conversion to a different type happens sort of implicitly by the system. And it happens because whenever you use multiplication, strings will be converted to numbers. And as a result, this will become a number 25, and then we're adding 5. Okay, something different happens if you actually use minus. So let's say we need to deduct some likes from this number of likes. And here, let's just say it is going to be minus 2. Now, in this case, the system will behave somewhat differently. Remember when we did number of likes plus 5, the result was 255. Whenever you use minus, in this case, strings will be automatically converted to numbers. In fact, let me run this page and we get the result 23. So the rule that you have to remember is that whenever you use plus and one of the arguments is a number and the other argument is a string, numbers will be converted to strings, and then the values are going to be concatenated together. Whenever you use minus, strings will be, it's going to be completely opposite effect. Strings are converted to numbers whenever one of the arguments of the string is another, and the, another argument is a number, and then strings converted to numbers, and then the actual subtraction will happen. So this will be, in this case, we get 23. So in this case, this is another example of type coercion. Again, it happens implicitly. Also, let's take a look at what happens when you use the division operation. So let's say that we need to divide this number of likes by 2. Let's run this page and see what happens. And we get 12.5, exactly as we would expect if 25 were a number. So the rule of thumb here is that plus is the one where numbers are converted to strings, minus, multiplication, and division, strings are converted to numbers. That's something very important to keep in mind. Also, just to reiterate, if you were to convert your string to a number explicitly, then under text, you will see this block convert to number. That will do it explicitly, basically forcing the string to become a number. This is it. It's once you understand it, the concept is very simple, but it's important to keep in mind and understand when those conversions will take place in your logic. Thank you for watching this video, and as always, happy Codeless coding.